वेलकम टू आईएससी प्लस वन हिस्ट्री क्लास. वी आर गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू लेसन थ्री, इकोनॉमिक सोशल एंड कल्चरल इम्पैक्ट ऑफ ब्रिटिश रूल. बिफोर गोइंग थ्रू द लेसन वी विल अंडरस्टैंड द ऑब्जेक्टिव्स ऑफ द लेसन. द ऑब्जेक्टिव्स आर इम्पैक्ट ऑफ मॉडर्न आइडियाज ऑफ यूरोप ऑन इंडियन एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन, रिफॉर्म मूवमेंट्स, ब्रह्मो समाज, द आर्य समाज, सर सैयद अहमद खान, स्ट्रगल अगेंस्ट कास्ट, अबॉलिशन ऑफ सती राइट्स, विडो री मैरिज एक्ट 1856, Female Infanticide Prevention Act 1870, the Age of Consent 1891, and the Impact of this Age of Consent Bill 1891. In our previous sessions, we had already discussed the impact of modern ideas of Europe on Indian administration, reform movements, Brahmo Samaj, Arya Samaj, Sir Sayyid Ahmad Khan, struggle against caste, abolition of Sati rights, Widow Remarriage Act of 1856. And in this session, we are going to discuss the Female Infanticide Prevention Act 1870, the Age of Consent 1891, and the Impact of Age of Consent Bill 1891. Before going ahead, we will go through the new terms of this lesson. Female infanticide, the deliberate killing of newborn female children. Consummation, the action of making a marriage complete. Amendments, changes. The Age of Consent, it was an act passed by the British government in 1891 which raised the minimum age of marriage of a girl from 10 to 12. The history of child infanticide was seen in ancient Greece, especially in two states of Athens and Sparta. Athens was famous for intellectual activities, whereas Sparta was a military state. In Sparta, if a child was weak, the child was put to death, because in Sparta the people used to believe that a weak child, a physically weak child, could not serve in the army. But in India, it was not child infanticide, it was female infanticide which was prevalent, especially in eastern part of Bengal, Orissa, Rajputs. In Rajputs, the clans of Chauhan and Surajbansis, and it was also there among lower peasants of Jats, Ahir and Gujars. The problem was so serious for the British government that the two volumes of the parliamentary papers on infanticide was tabled in the House of Commons. House of Commons is a lower house in the British Parliament, in 1824 and 1828. So the Female Infanticide Act was passed in 1870. Now we will discuss the main provisions of this act. The first provision was, the power to take measures in particular district was given to the British government. If they found that in any state the problem of female infanticide was more, they had this power to take up the actions in those particular districts. Then the second provision was, power to make rules. The British government could make rules to end female infanticide. The third provision was confirmation and publication of rules. The British government had the power to get confirmation on female infanticide bill from the enlightened, educated people of India, and after that publish the rules and regulations in the famous journals and newspapers. The next provision was that the British government could punish those who were violating the rules and regulation, punishment for breach of rules, and could give them punishment. The next provision was saving of prosecution under law. Prosecution means the legal proceedings. All the legal proceedings should be recorded so that they could be helpful for the British government in making any law. The next provision was power to place neglected children under supervision. All those children who were neglected by the society, they were to be kept under the British custody. And the last provision was the extent of the act. The government would decide the areas where this law would be applicable. And the government decided that it would be applicable in northwest provinces, in Awadh, Agra and Punjab. Awadh is modern day Lucknow. Apart from the female infanticide, other main issue was what should be the age of consent, what should be the age of marriage for girls in India. So age of consent bill was passed in 1891. The first act against child marriage was passed in 1860. It prohibited the consummation of marriage of a Hindu girl below 10 years of age. So according to the first ever act against child marriage, which was passed in 1860, the minimum age of girls to be married in India was 10 years. But according to the Age of Consent Bill 1891, it proposed to raise the age of consent from 10 to 12. And in passing the Age of Consent Bill, Behramji Marwanji of Malabar, Malabar is a place, so he was called as Behramji Marwanji Malabari, had played a vital role. He was born in 1852 and died in 1912. He was a Parsi poet, a journalist and social reformer of Bombay. He had published two journals called as the Malabari Notes, by which he has presented the miseries of young Indian girls to the British government. So because of his effort, the Age of Consent Bill was passed in India in 1891. And now we will discuss what was the impact of this Age of Consent Bill 1891. This Age of Consent Bill had a mixed reaction in India. Amrit Bazar Patrika, which was a vernacular newspaper in Bengali, it criticized the Age of Consent Bill. Even the middle class, enlightened, educated people of Bengal has also criticized it. Our freedom fighter, one of our well-known freedom fighter and assertive leader, Bal Gangadhar Tilak, has also opposed this bill through his Pune Sarvajanik Sabha. According to him, by interfering in the cultural life of the Indians, the British were getting another chance to extend their empire in India. Whereas the Indian Mirror, this was an English newspaper, welcomed the Age of Consent Bill. Bipin Chandra Pal, who was also an assertive leader, he also favored the passing of the Age of Consent Bill 1891. And due to that, some attempts were also made to kill him. Brahmo Samaj, which was set up by Raja Ram Mohan Roy, also favored passing of Age of Consent Bill and increasing the age of marriage of Hindu girls from 10 to 12. Now, this was the end of this lesson. So I would advise you to go through these links for further information of the topic thoroughly and discuss these questions. Discuss the role of Raja Ram Mohan Roy in social and religious reforms. Discuss the contribution of Arya Samaj in reforming Indian society. How did Indian reformers fight against caste system? And write a note on Widow Remarriage Act and Age of Consent Bill. These are the main questions of this topic. I would advise you to go through these questions and go through the YouTube links for more detail of this topic. I hope you have understood this topic with the help of the notes and the help of these links. I would advise you to make notes of above topic and go through all these questions. Thank you.